fuck that, man. Audio Traffickers Part 2. We want to welcome y'all back. I'm your host for the day, JB, with my
DJ Enipop.
Monday Bones.
Yeah, it's Audio Traffickers Part 2. How y'all been? Y'all been good?
I'm cool. And how are you?
Good, good, good.
How you been?
Busy.
Busy?
Extremely.
Yeah?
Yes.
Working?
Yes.
Yeah? You been working, son?
Like a freshly bought slave. for real. So I know last time we had a good time. We talked about a lot of stuff, right?
Yes.
Let's keep it music tonight.
Okay.
All right.
That should be easy, being that, you know, that's what we do.
Yeah, right.
Music is never easy. Don't ever let nobody tell you that.
So
we'll be talking on that.
I think, you know what I'm saying, one of the first things that come to my mind when I think of music, but also I'm, you know, thinking of sports, boxing, Soulja Boy and Chris Brown. What's y'all?
You think it should happen or not?
I don't know. I'm trying to think. It seems like it is going to happen because it seems like it's money
being involved.
Yeah, it's money involved now.
I just feel like if Chris Brown and Soulja Boy were not famous, that Chris Brown should beat the shit out of Soulja Boy. Only basically because, like, he really stepped out of line by posting a picture of his child. At that point, you went too far.
Yeah, I just
and tagging another man to it. Like, come on.
Yeah,
he posted a picture of Royal and tagged Floyd Mayweather to the picture. Like, that was too much. He says that Chris Brown FaceTimed him, telling him, mad because he liked the picture. And Chris Brown is saying, that's not even a conversation that we had. And basically woke up to Soulja Boy on the internet barking at him. And so he was
got the Draco.
He just had all the time for it that day when he woke up. He had all the time for it.
So does Chris Brown have to leg up since everybody know he 1-0, right?
That's wrong. So wrong. So wrong.
But, I mean,
I think he does have the leg up. Just
yo, they didn't bring my drum. I was supposed to have my snare drum right here.
Yeah, you needed your bell.
I need my snare.
If anybody saw the video of Soulja Boy shadow boxing at the camera, you will understand that he's going to lose.
It was the worst.
Okay?
It was the worst.
Chris Brown is going to do a flip over his head without a running start and then kick him in the back of his head, and it's just going to be over.
That nigga do know that ninja dance and shit.
He is Bruce Lee.
Chris Brown.
Said the ninja dance and shit? It's some ninja shit?
He's gonna
Ninja Gaiden.
Fuck.
It's just celebrity boxing, though. It's not.
He don't even need the gloves.
It's not even anything new, though. It's just celebrity boxing. It's just more relevant. I think more relevant.
People are mad.
And really, one of them ain't really relevant, but now has just made himself relevant again.
Who?
Soulja Boy.
Yeah. Yes.
Did we not talk about a new Soulja Boy record right now?
But you know what? You know what's crazy?
So what happens if he gets beat up? Is he still winning?
Somebody who hadn't heard of
Soulja Boy.
All he want to do is cash a check, so I say yes.
I guess that makes sense.
Even if he gets beat up?
Album,
I think he maybe winning
somebody go back and...
Even if he gets beat up.
Oh, he already won.
I think he winning because he was on Love and Hip Hop.
Even if you... So they're going to be like, so well, it's World Star.
That
anyway,
momentum
so
of I'm about to battle or fight a dude that's winning... Is
being on Love and Hip Hop really
him
winning?
So Chris
is that another topic for another day?
Is he even on anymore? That's probably why this is happening, because he doesn't have a storyline on Love and Hip Hop anymore.
But it was his name.
You get a check.
They get a check.
You get a check from
it. It's working. I'm talking about winning. That's the difference. I mean, we can have that conversation another day.
He's not winning, but his name out there.
But they working, so I'm not mad at that.
It's a check.
Yeah, it's definitely
talking about
people
that.
Look him up.
We talked about that with the inauguration, with the Chrisette Michelle. Remember we was talking about, look, Chrisette Michelle, she in a situation where she catch a flack for the national anthem or for whatever singing at Trump's inauguration. Mm-hmm. But is that just her working?
Well, I think on paper, what I saw, I don't know how correct, is it was $250,000. For her,
I saw both of those. $750,000.
But either way, yeah. she got three figures for it. But you think people gonna really? Because I saw gospel groups. See, people gonna turn on gospel groups too. Yeah, Chrisette Michelle performed with the gospel
choir.
Yeah. So I don't know if Urban America is gonna turn on them also.
Well, I think really my standpoint on Chrisette career wise, as in general, is not like A1 anyways. So her doing that, she just kind of likes securing the bag. I think it's, she knows, she sees what she sees where this is going. This is going to an Allstate commercial. You know, this is going, it's going there.
Yep.
You know, you did R&B Divas way before you was an R&B Diva. So you kind of ended it for yourself then.
I don't know what she does now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Didn't work.
I mean, I guess she doing, she's trying to finagle whatever she's finagling.
She's nice, though.
She secured the bag. But it's like, I don't know.
You don't think Chrisette Michelle can sing?
I can't.
Yes, she can sing. I do think she can sing. I'm talking about her career. I'm talking about her career.
It's about the check.
Yeah, she's securing the bag because she knows her career's not going to go up any further than it already was when we first.
I'm getting the check.
It's not, yeah, so she's securing the bag. For one, feel like it's still a sellout move. You're just securing the bag, but it's still a sellout move. But you're doing what you got to do, so it's like a catch 22. It's a catch 22.
By her?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a catch 22. Definitely.
Well, I say this. Hold on.
She's only doing it to secure the bag. Maybe she doesn't stand for it, but she's just doing it to get the money for it.
If it was a situation where she was like anti-Trump and didn't rock with Trump. And then did this, then like, I could say, okay, maybe you sold out. Right. But otherwise, if she didn't really have no affiliation with that,
let me say this.
What specifically did she sell out?
Steve Harvey been getting a check from him, though.
She gave, with the, she hid the fact that she signed on to do that. She knew it wasn't right in her mind. That's why she hid it.
So
that's a sellout move to me.
I kind of get that mentality.
To me, that's a sellout move.
Mm-hmm.
She so, yeah, start with herself. She lied to herself.
So speaking of like sellouts, is hip-hop going to turn on Mr. Family Feud?
Do hip hop even rock with him in the first place?
No.
He said he's from the inner city. He is hood.
But that's like Judge Mathis saying that shit.
And Ben Carson.
It don't really count.
But that's why he went to go meet. So he can correct the.
I mean, has Steve already been sitting down with Donald Trump? Since you know, since he did the American Miss Universe, he the one that rehired him.
But it's like, I listen to his morning show sometimes on the way to work and. You know what I'm saying? He been blasting. I'm talking about talking dog cash shit about Donald Trump heavy.
Right.
Before the election.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah, before the election. I mean, he was talking cash shit.
I'm not going to say he a sellout because no one knows what they talked about. So at the end of the day.
It doesn't matter. He posed for that photo op.
But it matters,
that's what
though.
Turns it into a sellout move to me.
True. What matters is what the conversation was before you got to the photo. You know what
my
I mean?
Shit don't crack.
The conversation might have been awesome. He might have kept it the way he's been keeping it. So, nobody knows.
So can Steve Harvey, Ray Lewis, and 87-year-old Jim Brown tell Trump what the inner city needs to flourish, or how can we change the inner city? You know what I'm saying?
If they was up there to do that, then I wouldn't you consider them a sellout, by the way. If they was up there with a specific cause.
But I'm actually, do they have the answers?
Just going up there to be like, all right, you know, let me pose.
Do they have the answers? Or, like, I don't know. I guess they might not be in touch with somebody really closer to the situation.
I mean, if it's for the inner city youth, it needs to be for the inner city youth of where you are. And if that's the case, you're still sitting down with the wrong people. You need to be sitting down with the people that's there in that city, not this.
Yeah, that's my whole take on it. That's my whole take. Sorry.
Fuck you, Donald Trump.
Did you hear the joint that they played last night?
They put a wall around your ass.
Did you hear the fuck you, Donald Trump?
Yo, they called them a potato. Yeah. They called them a potato last night. Yeah. It's like, yeah, the potato.
Did you hear the fuck you, Donald Trump?
Fuck Donald Trump.
Yeah, the girl, it was on my snap. I'll show y'all later.
That joint was dope.
Me and a fellow American citizen of fairer skin than me walked together and fucked Donald Trump last night.
Yeah, it sounded like him. It was some West Coast.
It was a West Coast song.
Yeah,
it was
dope.
It was
dope.
He did that last
My man played some joints last night, too.
And back
can, I, like, can I do a timeout?
Good.
No, not on this. On me. I need.
You need your phone?
Nope.
Oh, you didn't even got
to
stop recording.
I need to, like. I'm sorry, I like lift all my lip gloss.
Time out.
Makeup.
That's what I was like.
Makeup.
Like when I started drinking, that was cool.
What up, bro?
What up, good sir? Come here, son. We on the makeup break right now. What's good?
Oh, makeup break.
Getting everything. I got to move, yo.
We break.
I mean, you're right. I was gonna say you ain't got started. Shouldn't take that, but it's all right.
We talking about after that?
Yeah, the SoundCloud.
Okay. So,
ding, 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 ding.
Yeah, he dropped the bell.
Yeah, so come on, yo. I thought y'all hated my Bell last time. Like don't worry, she'll be back.
I like the Bell.
It'll never be the same. I'm gonna call her Willikim.
No.
Y'all crazy.
Next week you fry fish. You miss some stuff.
Yeah. So, well, my SoundCloud be booming, I think, a little bit. I know a lot of artists, I find out about a lot of new artists via SoundCloud. I don't know how they know the shit I want to hear, but I typically is introduced to maybe 3 or 4 new artists weekly that I rock with, just SoundCloud alone. So, really? 2018, you're going to be eligible for a Grammy through SoundCloud. What y'all think about that?
I mean, I feel like music streaming is very popular anyway. I'm actually a Spotify fan. I like Spotify more than SoundCloud, actually. Because you can put... It's like a different way of getting the body of work. Mm-hmm. Like, without having to... I don't know, take up so much space.
I know that... You know what I'm saying? I know the difference. You don't have to pay to get on SoundCloud. You know
that's
what I'm saying?
The difference for the artist.
Yeah.
Well, why wouldn't you invest in yourself in a market that's still going to be like, very those true. Streams count.
Very true. Very true. Very true. Speaking of...
And you sell your music on there as well.
By the time this drop, worst on case Spotify. Scenario, should be available. Download. On Spotify and Apple Music, iTunes, and all of those different outlets also.
Shameless. I mean, I'm not knocking SoundCloud. That's a good thing. But think about how many people have stuff on SoundCloud because it's free.
Yep. I wasn't a big advocate of SoundCloud at first, but I've grown to appreciate it. That's just crazy that you're going to be eligible for a nomination because, I mean, I guess anybody can put their
that's
music
what I'm saying,
on that
like,
platform,
correct.
Right?
I think it's the SoundCloud Pro.
You're paying for, okay. Yeah,
exactly. So, okay. Right. So okay. Either way, you got to invest in yourself, so it's the same thing.
So, same thing. Just a different way of trying to secure the bag, right?
True.
Yeah. So, like, I know we were talking earlier about, you know, certain artists that I know we rock with. In like their heyday, you know what I'm saying? The Fat Joes and the Locks and all of that. And mm-hmm. We was talking about, do you think they have, you know, is it that they want to still do music? Or do they feel like what's happening in the current state of hip-hop is kind of like...
Obligating them?
Yeah.
It might be a little bit of both. Just, you know, because they come for the culture. They come for it and from it. So they're here for it, you know what I mean? I feel like them... being signed and it being announced make people realize that it's still relevant. You know, the hip-hop that we know is kind of like being pushed to an underground stage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, well, you can still get bread, though. You know what I'm
right.
saying?
Right. And it's really more of an independent stage, actually, mm-hmm. which is better. But it's only it's better if you got West. Fans. It's only better if you got fans.
Yep.
So it don't matter what you're doing. Likes on the gram and shares and fake followers, if you make it or not, and you decide to step out on your own, it's gonna you'll have a hard time because you ain't gonna have no real fans.
And perception is reality, and it's really, I think, for the most
art imitate life.
For the most part, you know, it ain't really no rules to it. You can just go record. You can put your music out. Mm-hmm. You can get your fans. You end up start doing shows. You can. You know what I'm saying? You get your CDs pressed up, and you're an artist.
I think we usher into an era, too, where you're seeing, you know what I'm saying, artists from that genre that's still making music.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's because they want to make, you know what I'm saying, that music. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? We are artists. It's the same reason we make the music that we make. It's the same reason Bernard Hopkins won't stop fighting.
But based on his last episode, I'm a big fan.
I didn't even know what the results was of that
yo,
fight.
Yo, son, he literally beat that nigga out the ring.
Bernard Hopkins got beat out the ring?
Beat out the motherfucking ring.
Yo, did that really happen?
Yes. Yo, if you got the clip, show that shit right now.
Boom. He went through YouTube-worthy.
Yeah, but...
Really, they did that to B-Hop. But he fought. He did fight because he still wanted to fight. Yes, he had the passion to do
that
it.
Example.
Now, hopefully, ain't nobody right. Hopefully, ain't nobody
knocking through the
back
show
or the locks.
One example is when Jake Hope can jump on a track every other year, and when it dropped, everybody going to be like, yo, you heard Hope on that?
For the love.
Jay-Z said like 6 words on the last Drake joint pop style. He said like 2 sentences. And everybody was looking for it because Hov was on it. He said two sentences.
So speaking of, why do people like? Why do people try to put that age restriction on hip hop? Where you got, you know, rock and rollers, they perform and sell out arenas until like they could really die after they leave stage. That's facts. How old they are.
Very true.
Like, so very why true. Does
very
true. Why does hip hop put that? You know what I'm saying? Like that age limit. I always said Jay was gonna be the first dude on the Vegas Strip, hip hop dude, like having a night. You gonna go see Jay-Z in Vegas, like some Frank Sinatra
you think
shit.
That would be dope.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I don't think he'll do it.
Once he gets to that age. That. I mean, that's 10, but that's 10, 15 years from now.
Yo, that, but that's also like a badge,
that's
10,
15 years from now.
He's too cool for that.
That's also like a badge. Yo, when you get to a certain,
do you understand? We're talking about securing the
badge? As an artist, to be like, yo, I'm doing 3 weeks in Vegas?
I feel like if they present the right presentation for him, though, if it looked like,
it's
going to
be some
slime
shit.
It's going to be some slime shit.
You know, like, yo, I'm about to do my set every night.
Some sucker shit.
No, you a fucking liar. No.
No.
Yo, cut him. Mute him.
Forever.
This is audio travel. I need to mute him.
That's some bad of honest shit to be like, yo, yeah, I got my own 3 weeks in Vegas this week, and I'm about
going.
To kill every night.
I'm going
to be a draw every night. Yes.
I'm going.
That's
I'm
not
going.
No sucker shit. Yes, that's some dope shit.
Man, that comes
across.
But no,
fan.
But I don't
I'm
think
going.
That's some sucker. I think that.
Every time he
that's a
shot.
That's a
I
badge of approval.
Every time he
comes
to
give me somebody who's done it that it was a badge of approval.
But you think about it. I don't know what the number.
Frank Sinatra himself.
Frank Sinatra.
That was in the 60s.
I don't give a fuck. Vegas is still Vegas.
Name somebody else.
Celine Dion.
Not naming nobody else.
Celine Dion.
Yes.
At the end of the day.
Her career?
Nah.
Hey, look. At the end of the day, you still good.
None.
That has been done, and that's the whole
be the first.
Name an R&B artist.
Black,
there is
like R, like R&B soul, like
I don't know.
That's the point.
But
that's the thing. People think it's not. People think.
But
our people probably think it's that's something that we shouldn't do.
But we coming into that age.
Like it is.
Look, just what he was
like
just saying.
White folks VH1.
We are ushering into an age where these. We're
going
to see.
I remember
I
that.
I say the Vegas Strip is like white folks love hip hop.
No. What is you talking about?
I thought you meant like, I thought he was talking about the VH1 before they let like,
yo, it's dope
all the other shows.
To get
come
you
on.
3 weeks and rock out and make your shit dope.
I would go see that. I'll
people,
get it,
people should
because
be
I'll
ready
get,
to do
I'll get
that.
You
gotta
I'll
think
you,
of
be.
So many people
I'll
gonna be
you,
coming like part of that
Jay.
Show. He
but
just seen
that.
He could do that.
Well, back to the topic though.
We get into that era.
Back to the topic.
Could do Vegas.
Back to the topic. That exact reason.
Exactly.
And he's washed up.
Hold on.
Are you crazy?
He's playing.
But look.
The Get Down.
He's dope.
The Get Down.
I enjoyed the shit out of him when he came downtown.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what you do. That's what you're doing it for.
Yeah.
It's going
to
be a Vegas night. You
now
know what it is.
And look, it's washed. Is that what you think?
And that's the exact
you think
reason.
They do that because
that's the exact
for.
Reason why hip hop got an age limit.
Maybe so.
Because
maybe so.
It, because,
maybe so.
Because
like
just
you
the way
that
you
stay,
this dude
okay.
thinks.
That's why.
I feel like
why.
If you do reality
it's
TV, it might be over. But K. Michelle proved me wrong with that one.
That still needs that attention. Because remember when you was growing up, people wasn't feeling.
But there's the bag. That's why I say the Grandmaster Flash rocks now. Because
right.
he needs to get his money from where he missed it. Jay missed his money.
Right, I get what you're saying. You're looking at it from a different standpoint.
Right. Jay never missed his money. Jay got his
he's
money.
He's someone
that's
not reachable. So.
The new cats. Like, the Grandmaster Flash didn't get the money.
So what's the difference between Jay doing 3 weeks in Vegas and Jay saying I'm going on tour for 3 months?
They can't
months.
See the whole thing.
But he's not going to go on tour.
But I'm saying, but what's the difference?
Vegas is, it's kind of like the fade right off into the sunset shit. I'm done.
Yeah, it would have to be when he's done. Let me be clear about that. I don't think it's a situation
so
where it's like I'm about to come back.
Back
and drop another album after I do that. I think when
no,
you
listen.
Do that, you're pretty much chilling.
Nah.
That's like
listen.
Instead of...
I don't think so.
Shit.
No,
I don't think it's like
the people
you're
that have done it
and you're doing
that.
I think it's
kind of
like
it.
I'm chilling right now.
I think it's like
and I'm about
because
to get
of the
this
history
money
of
and
it,
still
y'all.
Rock out.
Like Mariah just did it, right? Hold on. But she in the studio with Khaled right now.
Are we going tomorrow?
Like she's not gonna
not
keep making music. She's not gonna not stop putting out music after she do Vegas. She not.
Oh, no, artist is. Like, that's we are in an age, just like you said, because rock and roll people don't do it. R&B singers do that shit. But we are coming into the age where as hip hop is going to be able to do that. The people that we grew up with listening to and watching, they still making music. Fat Joe still making music. Mm-hmm. The Lox still making music. Busta Rhymes still making music. Tribe Called Quest still making music.
Yeah.
You are in that age where you're getting ready to start. See, I feel like, okay, you can go to a Coliseum and you might see these three acts.
Like, we need more Rock the Bells. Whoever did Rock the Bells.
But it's not going to be young people there. You don't see young people at old, you know, Stones or ACDs or DC concerts. You see older people.
You see a little bit of both.
But you have that fan. I mean, you're going to have those younger kids who got an appreciation for something like that, but it's going to be a primarily older-based audience, and I think that's what you're going to get to. Even when we perform, you see who your core audience is. You know what I'm saying? Your fans typically ain't going to be 21, 22, 23 years because they listen to a certain type of music. But there's millions of our genre hip-hop fans out there, and I think they're going to continue to rock with their artists into that, you know what I'm saying, next phase of their career.
Cool.
So how do you feel about the newer age when they start going into the 21s, the Lil Uzi Vert, the Kodak Blacks?
But you can't say that when you still have people like Chance the Rapper and Childish Gambino. That's age. They're going to age shit. Young people who are very conscious of what the hell's going on in real life.
It's definitely not age. It's really your environment.
Yeah, it's definitely correct. Your demographic of us, exactly.
And it's their hip-hop, because even when we came up, our hip-hop wasn't the older cats' hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? True. So, and they really didn't... Because they was talking about, man, why y'all talking about shooting so much and selling so many drugs? Yeah. And
right.
Why y'all talking about that? They came from the party era.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They was partying. They was wearing wild shit, like feathers and sequins pants and
shit. No, we was wearing cross-color.
Nah, they was wearing sequins pants and...
I got a cross-color shirt right now.
Yeah, it was wearing cross-color.
You know what I'm saying? All type of wild shit.
When you say they, I'm saying I.
Me too. Yeah, I was wearing cross-color. Carl Kanai. Yeah. Ellie Hansen.
So look, I'm about to introduce something to Audio Travis called Salute to the State, since we from the Cat.
Okay.
So I'll start it. Just think about something about the state right now in regards to whether, you know, it's an artist that you rock with, something that's popped off from the state that you would just want to big up right now. So, I mean, on the top, man, I know just recently, big shouts to the homie DJ Luke Nasty from the state. You know what I'm saying? Just went gold. I wish I had a bell. Just went gold Luke off Nasty. His single.
Happy
you know
birthday.
What
it's his birthday weekend right now.
And you know what was crazy? So I was in Dallas, you know what I'm saying, a few weeks back. Big shouts to my brother and them for their championship. And I promise you, it had to have been maybe like three or four radio stations, hip-hop stations in Dallas. Mm-hmm. I tuned into every one of them, and every one of them was playing Luke Nasty.
That's awesome.
I was in Dallas. So, big up to that, man.
I want to big up Luke just for always being you, bro. You have not changed. You have not let this game change you. Don't let it stick to your shit, bro. All
right, so what you got for your salute to the state?
I'm going to salute Live Wire Studios.
Okay.
Okay.
That's all you got on that? That's period? Livewire Studios period?
Yeah,
all right, you see that. Put the period.
I want to salute Ilpo.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Worst case scenario.
We're not up for nomination.
We're not up for nomination.
All right, well, today, you know, I had a pretty busy day rocking out with a lot of things that's going on in Greensboro. Yeah. So if you don't mind, I have more than one. Shout out to my 85 Central crew web series
out in the Triad area.
Working on season 2, you know what I'm saying? And also, shout out to the homie Tego B, CNN.
He did shoot his track video
CNN
today.
Is going up. Yeah, he shot his video today for the joint. It's getting played all over, you know. 102 Jam definitely supports the record. I am a Mix Squad DJ. I'll be on the radio next weekend.
Plug.
Listen, Linda. So, I don't know if anything else y'all wanted to kind of chat about before we wrap up.
I know what we didn't talk about is what this episode is brought to the people Everything Music Magazine.
Nice little cover there.
They definitely hold it down. Artists of different genres.
My man Trey Magic right there. Trey Magic right there.
Y'all need to pay for them ads.
Trey the Magician.
Get up in here.
Don't be disrespectful. Zoom in on my man, Sam Frazier. Yes.
You know what I'm saying? What he do?
Yo, the green and the guitar is splashing very well with the green in his top.
And the name
on his blouse.
Sam Frazier. Big ups to you, Sam.
Yo,
we got anything else before we get out of here, man?
Nah, man. Hey, I just want to thank everybody that's been rocking with us the Audio Traffickers, man.
And we're about to start actually bringing the Audio Traffickers to a city near you. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be showing up at your local venues. You know what I'm saying? You might see us. We might have some special guests with us. So we're about to take this thing to another level.
Oh, yeah. And if any businesses want to sponsor, you know what I'm saying, want to throw something in for, and we can go to put your product out here, just like my man Sam Frazier. Mm-hmm. He's that dude. Yo, you can go out and hit up Livewire Studios on their Facebook page, and we'll get you in there, all right? So, all right?
Just turn her up loud.
Yeah.
That's going to be it, being said.
Yo, as always, I'm Jay Bond.
DJ Enopop.
I'm Monday Boons.
This is Audio Traffickers.
Peace.
Play the outro shit. Hold on. This is the outtake. So, of the young hip hop dances, what's your favorite dance right now? Of the young hip hop, I do mine first.
Y'all got to do it.
I'm gonna do mine first.
Do it.
Why?
Go do it.
I'm gonna do mine first.
Go do it.
It's gonna be the folk.
No, you gotta get.
Oh.
Yeah, that's my shit.
Did you just crump? Did you just crump right now? Was I in the crump battle? Did I just get crump?
What's yours, yo? I hit it with the My son showed me that
Come on, you gotta do it one time.
No. Do it, son.
Do it one time.
Do it.
Let me see it.
Chris, do the Pee Wee Herman. Do the Pee Wee Herman.
Like he's body slamming somebody like this.
You gotta do the jump.
You gotta do the
Reggie Miller.
So his dance is the folk.
Yeah, mine's the folk.
Street Zion.
Yeah, it don't matter how you.
Okay,
what's yours,
he did so mine. Mine is. You know what I'm saying? I like to. You know what I'm saying? But, like, you're supposed to do it real smooth, but I be wanting to do it.
What's yours, son?
I don't even know the new dance.
What's your favorite dance?
The Pee Wee Herman.
Do it.
So you gotta hit him with the phone.
Do it, son. They don't know that. Get busy,
yo.
Okay. Peace, Audio Traffic.
Once in a while, like you.